Hi everyone and welcome back. Let's see the other set of second set of this. So we have person as a function, and here we have created the object of the person, and here we are adding one prototype property, you can say, to the person function and trying to get person dot get full name. Now here is the point. Here we have created the object and here we are adding a function. So this function will not be available to the member object. Let me see. Member.getFullName, for me it should be a type error, but we can read the explanation. Functions object, therefore the method getFullName get added to the constructor function object itself. For the reason we can call person.getFullName, but will throw a type error. Then you have to add it to the prototype property. That is correct. So if you want to access a getFullName, you can actually add it anywhere, but you have to add it to the prototype of the person function, so then you can access it. Okay, so this is a nice explanation. Here is the same thing, okay, little bit different. Here we have a person function, we created the object of the person, and here we are creating this, we are just calling the function. Here we are creating the object of the person, so this should represent an object, and this is just a calling a function, right? It is not returning anything, so it should be undefined. So answer should be A for this. Okay, what are the three phases of event propagation? So there are a lot of concepts in JavaScript: bubbling, capturing, where you are actually, when you click on any DOM element, there is a capturing happens, then bubbling happens. So capturing, target, and bubbling. Capturing happens from top to bottom, and then bottom to top, bubbling happens. So answer should be D. You can see the explanation: capturing from top to bottom and then bubbling. All objects have a prototype, that is, should be false. Object have a prototype except the base object. The base object is the object created by the user. So whenever we are creating a new object, the base object has access to some methods and properties. Okay, coming to this, what will be the output? Sum A, B. So you can see we are actually concatenating a string to a number. So it should be 1, 2, because A is a number and B is a string. So it should be C without any issue. What will be the output of this? These are increment, decrement always gives us a trouble. Number, it should be 1, 1 and then 2. Okay, number plus plus. Okay, so it will not increase the number and it will print. So first one will be 0, then second should be 0 and then 1 and then 2. 0, 2, 2. Okay, 0, 2, 2. Do we have? Let's see. Yes, 0, 2, 2. Because it will not increment, it will print first, then it will increment, and it's a prefix, so it will increment first before printing, and then it's the same number. Okay, so what we are doing here is we have the function, we are trying to print 1, 2, 3. And here we have person equal to this. What is this? Get person info. We don't have a brackets here to call this person is year old. Get person info. So person is, I'm not sure about it how it is going to work, but maybe these are going to be passed as a rest parameter, like this will be the 1, this will be 2, and this will be 3, or 1, 2, 3. So person is this, is because all are string. Let's see the explanation for this and we'll understand. You use the tag template literals. The value of the first argument is always an array of string values. The remaining argument gets the value passed in the expression. Okay. Okay, so what it is saying is, when you are passing, this is the template literals, all the dynamic values will be assigned to the rest of the argument, and whatever the static we have is year old, first will be empty, second will be is, then year old. This is a little tricky, but yeah, this is how it works. You can also pass a template literals as an argument, so all the dynamic values will get assigned to the last values, all the static values, all static string will be assigned to 1. Okay, what is the output of this? Check age data. Here we are passing objects. Object triple equals to this data will be a false. Double equals will also be a false. So you should get this one C. Yes, because you can't, if you compare these objects, it is comparing the object reference. You can do object.is for that. Type of argument, okay, interesting question. So what happens is people get confused that because arguments is something like ES5 also argument is an array like, but that is indirectly an object, not an array. Here you are actually explicitly passing 21, so it should be passed as an array. Type of argument should be, I mean, it should be an object. See, and the last question here is, okay, so here age is 21 and you are using use strict, so there will be no collision of variables from the global scope. Age is 21. Here you are actually adding age 21 to the global scope because you are not declaring it using var or let keyword. So when you are trying to print it age, it is trying to get it from the global scope, but using use strict you have actually added a wall of China, the boundary here. So it should be undefined, not a reference error, I think. Undefined to define C, that is correct. Use strict, you can make sure that you don't accidentally access the global variables, right? And whatever you are declaring using age is adding to the global variables. Okay, let's talk the rest of the third set of videos in the next video. Thanks everyone.